Hi, today we wanted to give you some advice and talk about the maintenance of a CNC milling machine. Ranging from daily good practice to a presentation of the most common CNC mechatronic systems and how to maintain them to optimize the precision, the efficiency, and the durability of your machine. There are many types and variations of milling machines on the market. So in order to illustrate the video, we'll be using our Mekanika CNC wrench, but all the information given will be valid for any other brand. So let's get started.
First of all, keeping your CNC clean of milling dust and chips is the easiest way to help it stay in good working condition. Dust will accumulate over time, and that can induce a loss in mechanical precision, so cleaning it after each milling session is a must.
The greased parts will tend to accumulate dust regardless. So once in a while, you can do a deep clean of those parts. But remember that you will need to apply a new coat of grease before using your machine again. We'll explain this more in depth in the next chapters.
Talking about dust, a reminder that electronic boxes should be protected from dust as much as possible, because you should not open them unless your warranty allows you to do so, and that you are confident in doing it. On Mekanika machines, the control units have a filter on the fan to help protect it, and it can easily be cleaned without opening the box. Once in a while, check the cable runs and the sensors of your machine. Make sure the cables haven't been pinched or damaged and that sensors are working properly by checking their connection and testing them manually. If your Mekanika Evo sensor's connections are too loose, you can press a bit their connectors with pliers to make them tighter. Vibration might loosen some screws over long periods of time, so once in a while, make sure the whole machine is tightened.
It is possible to add a thread locker adhesive to all the screws to avoid this problem, but it can make your life harder if you need to replace a part in the future. So the choice is yours.
And another important point is the machine stability. So adjust the leveling fit or use shims if your machine doesn't have fit until it is perfectly stable.
Now we can focus on the most important parts to maintain, the mechatronics parts, which are the motion parts. There are two main groups: the drive systems, responsible for the machine movements, and the guiding systems, accountable for the precision of those movements. We recommend turning off the machine completely for the next steps, to avoid any danger when putting your hands in a moving part, and it will also allow you to push the gantry manually to access every corner.
Let's begin with CNC drive systems. Timing belts are often used for lighter CNC applications, like 3D printing or laser cutting. But with a proper setup, they are definitely able to handle milling too. They allow an entry into the CNC milling world without the higher cost of advanced drive systems. Belts and pulleys are open to external conditions, so you should regularly check their integrity and soiling. Inspect them and remove any residues that might be stuck inside their grooves and on both belts' faces. Work properly, a belt must be in tension. If they are too loose, they might skip some steps when running, but if they are too tight, they will prevent smooth movement and wear out prematurely. On a Mekanika Evo, you can adjust the belt's tension by pulling them with a finger as much as possible. Those belts are very stiff, so it is highly unlikely that you will be able to over-tension them by hand.
If you want to go more in depth and study the effects of different belt tensions on your milling results, you would need a tensiometer to run some tests and to find the sweet spot for your machine. So I will put a link in the description to an open source 3D printable tensiometer model if you're interested in doing so.
Ball screws and lead screws are the most common drive system for milling machines. They are endless screws translating a circular movement to a linear movement through a nut moving along the shaft.
Lead screws or acme screws are cheaper and reliable, but they tend to have a problematic characteristic for CNC milling called the backlash. By design, there must be a little bit of free space between the nuts and the shaft's grooves. Otherwise, friction would prevent the movement. So when the shaft pushes the nut in the direction and then stops and goes the opposite way, the shaft will move without pushing the nut until it has covered that little distance. Backlash is that little distance in which the motor and the shaft spin, but the nut doesn't move. It results in a little desynchronization between the machine's theoretical coordinates and its actual position. It's a small difference, but still a problem when you want to do precision milling.
If your machine uses lead screws, like the Mekanika Evo Z-axis, it is likely equipped with an anti-backlash system that minimizes this problem by using preloaded nuts that have two grooves instead of one. On Evo, it is the special split nut. Using that screw, you can space the nuts apart so that they enter in contact with the shafts on both sides, reducing backlash. Don't over-tighten it, or the friction will increase greatly and movement will be restrained. Precision ball screws are an alternative to lead screws, and they have many advantages. They use preloaded nuts filled with ball bearings that keep a permanent contact with the shaft, avoiding any backlash. But it also removes sliding frictions thanks to the rolling nature of ball bearings, making them much more efficient than lead screws. This is why ball screws are commonly used on higher grade CNCs, such as the Mekanika Pro and Fab. Lastly, all drive screws must stay clean and lightly greased at all times. When needed, you can clean them with alcohol as suggested earlier, but then you must apply a new coat of grease. Put a small knob of grease on the screw before and after the nuts, and move the axis back and forth a few times to spread it.
You can use any brand of grease labeled for ball bearings, preferably lithium grease. But be careful, never use old base lubricants such as the classical WD-40, as they will eventually evaporate and leave the dry system exposed.
After a certain length, screws tend to introduce vibration and undulation. So machines are often equipped with rack and pinion drivetrains for very long axes, such as the Mekanika Fab's Y-axis. Racks and pinions allow for a clean linear motion, but as they use grooves instead of ball bearings, they are subject to some backlash too. To reduce backlash on racks, there are tensioning springs that push the pinion closer to the rack, making sure that grooves remain in optimal contact. For maintenance, you can check the spring's tension. On a Mekanika Fab, you can tighten the spring completely, then release the screw for 3 full rotations to give it the right tension. You can then also adjust the belt tensioning pulleys placed under the pinions to make sure the belts are properly adjusted.
Long racks are often split in several parts, and it is important that they are correctly spaced and aligned, as if there was no junction. This should have been set correctly during the machine assembly, but it doesn't hurt to check if it is still correctly set.
The trick is to use a third rack of the same type to perfectly space out and align the grooves of two sections, so that the pinion goes from one to the other seamlessly.
Finally, racks are dry running, so they don't specifically need to be greased, but it can help to protect them from wear and rust. So you can apply lithium grease also, but in a very small amount, so the grooves don't get filled with milling residues.
Now let's talk about the CNC guiding systems. A common entry-level guiding system is the use of wheels guided by grooves or rails. They are inexpensive, but they are exposed to dirt accumulation, so maintenance is very important on those systems to keep the precision rate high. The contact surfaces of both wheels and guides needs to be clean and dry. Remove any residue that might alter the movement without forgetting the lower parts of the carriages.
The pressure applied by the wheels on the rails must be checked too.
When pushing carriages on the axis, they should move easily without any resistance or jerking. If it is hard to move, the wheels are too tight. When pushing the carriages out of their moving axis, you should not feel any movement. If you can feel some, the wheels are too loose. On a Mekanika Evo, each wheel has an eccentric nut to set their pressure. Check a wheel by trying to spin it with a finger. If it is free running, turn its nut clockwise to tighten it until it engages the rail. Turn it the other way around if it blocks the carriage. The higher grade of guiding systems are linear rails. Those are manufactured to be very precise, and their sliding blocks use ball bearings providing a smoother motion while being protected in an enclosure. There are cylindrical rails and prismatic rails, also called square or profile rails. Cylindrical rails are reliable but considered less stiff than prismatic rails when under heavy load, which CNC milling is subject to. Sliding blocks on prismatic rails also have a larger contact surface, providing extra stability. And for those reasons, prismatic rails are often preferred in CNC milling.
Just like the drive screws, the sliding blocks and the rails must stay lightly greased to function properly.
So you can clean them with rags when they need it, and then apply a new coat of grease. Remember to always use lithium grease labeled for ball bearings, and never oil-based lubricants.
Sliding blocks usually have a valve to inject grease inside using a grease gun, and this is the optimal way to do it. But if you don't have a grease gun, applying grease manually on the rail is also perfectly fine.
Put a knob of grease on the rails and then move the blocks back and forth a few times to fill them with grease too. You can then remove the excess to avoid dust accumulation.
So let's summarize the advice for CNC maintenance. First of all, clean your machine after each milling session. Vacuum all you can, then use an air compressor to remove the rest of the chips. You can then make a proper maintenance when the machine has been used a lot. Check that all the cables, sensors, and electronics are in a good position and in a good condition. Make sure the machine is stiff and stable. If your machine uses belt drive systems, clean the pulleys and the belts and check their tension. If it has endless screws, clean them and apply a new coat of grease. For rack and pinion trains, clean the grooves and check the different tensioners installed. In a guided wheel system, all the contact surfaces of both wheels and rails must be clean and dry. And for machine using linear rails, you can clean them and apply a new coat of grease. There are, of course, some other systems used in CNC milling machines we didn't mention here, but those are the most common ones. Now, if you own a Mekanika CNC and have additional questions about its maintenance, we have online support documentations and troubleshooting guides to help. But you can also send us a request on our support page where we usually answer within the next 24 hours. I hope it was helpful and instructive to you, and feel free to check our other educative content on our channel to learn more about CNCs. I'll see you there. Bye.